Jai Gurudev, happy day children. I'm fine here. Hope so you all are fine there. Today, we are going to see a special type of number. Already we have seen many types of numbers, but today we are going to see a special type of number. I think you have guessed it. Already we have seen many types of numbers. Whole numbers, natural numbers, integers, decimal numbers, prime numbers, composite numbers, and so on. In whole numbers, we have the numbers starting from 0, 1, 2, 3, and so on. And in natural numbers, we have the numbers starting from 1, 2, 3, and so on. In integers, the whole numbers and natural numbers together will come and they will have positive and negative sign. These type of numbers we have already seen. And now we are going to see a special number where a fractional and integers together will come. I think you have guessed it, children. Yes, today we are going to see rational numbers. Already we have seen this rational numbers in the previous class with the basic operations: addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. Also the standard form. Today we are going to see the rational numbers in different way. This is new to you. We are going to see the properties of rational numbers. Rational numbers is nothing but which is represented in P by Q form along with the positive and negative sign. For example, 1 by 5, minus 2 by 7, minus 17 by 25, 1, 0. How 1 can be a rational number? Yes, 1 can be written as 1 by 1. And 0 can be written as 0 by 0 or 0 by 1. Anyway, we'll get the answer 0. So these all are called the rational numbers. Now, let me see the properties of rational numbers. We have closure property, commutative property, associative property, identity, inverse. These all are the properties of rational numbers. Already we have seen these properties in your lower classes with the whole numbers, integers, and the natural numbers. I think you remember it. Okay, let me see one by one. First, we'll go for the closure property. In the closure property, we will take all the four basic operations and we will check whether the whole number gets satisfied with all the basic operations. First, I'll take the whole number 5 and 4, and when two numbers are added, I'm getting the whole number 9. So we can tell that whole numbers are closed under addition. Then I'll go for the subtraction. I am taking the whole numbers 5 and 7. 5 minus 7 equal to minus 2, where minus 2 is an integer and not a whole number. So we can tell that whole numbers are not closed under subtraction. Then multiplication. Two whole numbers 5 and 5 are multiplied, where we are getting the whole number. So we can tell that whole numbers are closed under multiplication. Finally, I am going for the division. 5 divided by 7, in which we are getting a fractional number. So whole numbers are not closed under division. So we can tell that in the four basic operation, for addition it is true, subtraction it is not true, we are getting an integer, and multiplication it is true, and for the division it is not true. Children, you can try with more examples by working like this with all the basic four operation. Next, I have taken the natural numbers, where first I checked with the addition, 7 plus 5 equal to 12, where I got the same whole number. Then I went with 6 minus 7, where I got the minus 1. So subtraction is not closed for natural numbers. Multiplication, it is true. And for division, again we got the fractional number, so it is not true. So for the natural numbers, addition, it is true. Subtraction, it is not true. Multiplication, it is true. And division, it is not true. Next, we go for the integers. I have taken some integers, minus 3, minus 7. When these two are added, we are getting minus 10 integer. Next, minus 4, minus 5. Where I have subtracted both the integers, I got minus 7. Obviously, it is also an integer. Then, multiplication. 7 into minus 6, which is equal to minus 42. It is an integer? Yeah, you're right. It is an integer. So, for addition, subtraction, multiplication, we got a true result. That is, we got the integers as the answers. When I go for the division, minus 5 by 8, minus 5 by 8. It is a rational number. While calculating two integers, I am getting a rational number. So, in division, it is not closed. Integer is not closed under division. Finally, coming to the rational numbers. I have taken minus 1 by 2 and 3 by 4 for the addition. While adding these two rational numbers, I got 1 by 4, a rational number. So, addition is true for rational numbers. Next, subtraction. 3 by 4 minus 1 by 4, which we will get 1 by 2. So, subtraction also true for rational numbers. Then, multiplication. I have taken two rational numbers, 3 by 4 and 5 by 6, where I am getting another rational number as the answer. So, multiplication is also true for rational numbers. Finally, division. 4 by 5 divided by minus 6 by 7. Next step, 4 by 5 into 7 by minus 6, which we will change into a reciprocal. So finally, we got 28 by minus 30, where it is a rational number. Yeah, it's a rational number. Good. But you know one thing, minus 3 by 7 divided by 0. Okay, 0 is a rational number. Right, we have seen in the previous slide. Minus 3 by 7 divided by 0, it is undefined. We cannot do that. So, for division, it is not true for rational numbers. As we have seen the closure property for different types of numbers, next we are going to see the commutative property. Do you remember what is meant by commutative property? Yes. When we interchange two numbers for the basic operation, we will get the same answer. First, we will deal with the whole numbers. While taking the addition, 7 plus 5 equal to 12, whereas 5 plus 7 is also 12. So, whole numbers are commutative under addition. Next, subtraction. 8 minus 7 equal to 1, whereas 7 minus 8 equal to minus 1. So, subtraction is not commutative for whole numbers. For multiplication, when the factors are interchanged, we are getting the same answer. So, multiplication is true. Next, we will go for the division. 4 divided by 6 is equal to 2 by 3, whereas 6 divided by 4 equal to 3 by 2. Here we can tell the division is not commutative for whole numbers. Next, for the natural numbers, addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. Same way as whole numbers, natural numbers are taken and we have proved with these examples. From this, we can tell that natural numbers are commutative under addition and multiplication, and they are not commutative for subtraction and division. Next, we will prove the commutative property for integers. Addition, it is true. Subtraction, true. Multiplication also true. But division, it is not true. We are getting a rational number as given in the example. Children, you can also take some integers and prove the following basic operations. You will get the answers. So, for integers, we can observe that for addition, subtraction and multiplication, the commutative property is true, and for the division, it is not true. Next, it is rational numbers. I have taken two rational numbers, minus 5 by 7 and 2 by 9, and I have done the addition. By taking LCM and doing the unlike fraction addition, we will get minus 31 by 63. Children, you have to work out this roughly. So, from this we can observe, for the commutativity, we have to interchange the numbers. So, 2 by 9 plus minus 5 by 7, where I am getting the same answer, minus 31 by 63. From this, I can tell that addition of rational numbers is commutative. Next, for the subtraction, 3 by 4 minus 2 by 5. Children, you have to work out this by taking the LCM. You will get the answer 7 by 20. Next, by interchanging the numbers, 2 by 5 minus 3 by 4, we are getting minus 7 by 20, where we are getting a rational number, but both the answers are not same. So, subtraction of rational number is not commutative. Next, for the multiplication, we are getting the same answers. So, multiplication of rational number is true for commutative. Finally, division. In division, we are getting different answers. So, we can tell that division of rational number is not true for commutative. Children, please take some more rational numbers and try all the four basic operations and check it. Next, we are going to see the associative property. Do you remember what is the associative property? We will take three different numbers and we'll check in the rule for associative property. That is, for example, for whole numbers, 4 plus 0 plus 5 equal to 9. The same way, 4 plus 0 plus 5 equal to 9. So, we are getting the whole numbers for both the answers. So, addition is associative. Next, subtraction. 8 minus 2 minus 4 is not equal to 8 minus 2 minus 4. While working out this, you will get two different types of answers. So, we can tell that subtraction is not associative. Next, multiplication. 3 into 7 into 4 equal to 3 into 7 into 4, where we are getting both the sides the same answers. Children, you have to work out this in a rough paper. From this, we can tell that multiplication is associative. Next, 8 divided by 4 divided by 2 is not equal to 8 divided by 4 divided by 2. So, we can tell that division is not associative. From this, we can tell that for the whole numbers, addition and multiplication is true, and for the subtraction and division, it is not true. We will see for the natural numbers. Addition and multiplication, it is associative, and subtraction and division, it is not associative. Children, you will work out with some examples and you will submit as an assignment for natural numbers, integers and rational numbers. This will be submitted as an assignment at the end of this session. Children, I have given the associativity for the four basic operations and you will be submitting the sums as an assignment for integers also. Same way, for rational numbers, take three rational numbers and do the addition, subtraction, multiplication and division and check the associativity for rational numbers also. Now, we will see the additive identity of rational numbers. What is meant by additive identity? When we add a number with one number, we should get the same number. That is, I'm taking the number 3. When I add the number 3 with one number, I should get the same number 3. What is it? 0. Yeah, good. When I'm taking a number and adding with 0, I'll get the same number. Here, the identity is 0. While adding an identity, we are getting the same number. That is the additive identity. And for the rational number, the additive identity is 0. So, for rational number, integer, natural number, and whole number, the identity, additive identity is 0. Next, multiplicative identity. What is that multiplicative identity? Same as additive identity only. When we add, we are getting the same number. When we are adding, we are getting the same number. Same way, when we are multiplying two numbers, we are getting the same number. For example, 3 into what comes 3? 1. Same way, when we are taking a number and multiplying with a number, we should get a same number. That is applicable for whole number, natural number, integer, and rational number. Obviously, it is 1. So, the multiplicative identity of rational number is 1. Not only rational number, for all the varieties of number whichever we have taken, the multiplicative identity is 1. Additive inverse of a number. That is negative. What is that additive inverse? Inverse means opposite. While we are taking a negative number, the inverse is positive. While taking a positive number, the inverse is negative. So, the additive inverse of a rational number is the opposite number. For example, the negative of 4 by 5 is minus 4 by 5. The additive inverse of minus 7 is 7. The additive inverse of 1 is minus 1. The additive inverse of 4 is, minus 4. The opposite sign, we should write the opposite sign of the given number. That is the additive inverse of a number. Multiplicative inverse of a number. What is that multiplicative inverse? It is a reciprocal. That is, for a rational number, the multiplicative inverse of A by B is B by A. We should not bother about the sign here, the positive or negative. It will be the same only. For example, multiplicative inverse of 1 by 4 is 4 by 1. Multiplicative inverse of minus 2 by 3 is 3 by minus 2. Multiplicative inverse of 8 is 1 by 8. And here we can see that 0 has no reciprocal. Why? Because 0 by 1 is that number. So, while taking the multiplicative inverse, we will have 1 by 0, which is undefined. So, we can tell that 0 has no reciprocal. Children, you have to find out the multiplicative inverse which is given in the exercise, and you will get a clear knowledge about the multiplicative inverse.